Ladies and gentlemen, we are back. Puckett, Duffman, and Swanee. The players are giving us no time to pee, so we're just going to pee in our chairs. Guys, it's time for game number four. This is Prophecy taking on Stunner. Just let it go.
Just a quick overview of the map before the action gets started. What you want to do, ideally, Stunner are on the good side here, predominantly because their flag area is exposed. It's easy to get shots on the flag carrier. They want to get the ball, run it into school, maintain school control, and just go in for the easy dunk. Otherwise, get map control and run it through mid-road for the throw.
Look at that performance from Parasite, opening up 3-0, stopping the push before they can get to school. Now he's going for the long ranger, Vexipoo, with the interception.
Yeah, and I've seen that a few times actually from Prof. I think they've been practicing them relentlessly in private matches, to be honest. You can actually throw the ball from pretty much the pickup point on top of the first hard point, the reset point, straight to the point.
Huke with the objective, throws out a stun, picks back up the satellite, but doesn't get it very far. Vexipoo is going to be moving this up, 3 down for Prophecy, all on respawn. This is a 2-point play, and Vexi is going to put it in our first minute.
Picks up a kill as well. Causing more problems. Huke's going to try to apply the pressure on the base. He will drop 3 down temporarily there for Stunner. Meanwhile, we'll switch on over to Vex. 5-2 already, a dunk to allow Stunner to take a 2-point lead over Prophecy. What a great start for them.
Swanee, talk to me about this yellow writing in the clan tag for Perplex. What the hell does that mean?
I'd love to give a detailed explanation, but I have no clue.
Some of the cool players are all blanked out. Perplexed is one of them. Fears legal up currently for Prophecy, trying to stop this push. Here comes Huke, though. Huke getting cut down. Perplexed pushing in. Going to find one. Looking for a second. That ball still on the ground. And it looks like we're going to see Parasite try and clear. Solid push from Parasite. He's going to get to the alleyway and almost gets around the corner. If he does that, that could have converted into a 2-point play, and it looks like Legal and Fear still trying to push it through.
You see just how hard it is. You see, absolutely huge stop, but you see just how hard it is on the side that the Prof runner actually get control of the opposition's face and cap that ball, because the team literally spawned in front of them, and it was the route they took, it was just an easy stop.
TJ, last man standing, trying to get it by 3 players. Not going to happen, says Ricky. And Ricky now with our satellite pushing center. Duffman, take it away.
He's going to be hanging out, trying to stay alive, wait for his teammates to get a little support. Tosses it. That was a flub toss. He's trying to get it over, I think, into the side. But he'll keep it just reset towards the middle. Picked up for the moment by Stunner. Three down, though, for a Stunner. Here comes an opportunity for Prophecy to score.
Vexy's just trying to stop it. Not going to happen. Now Legal with the satellite. And really, Prophecy hasn't been able to get inside the Stunner base at all this game. And there's another big stop. Ricky, last man up, 4 down. Stunner going to try and push this one through. They know exactly where they're going with it. And so does Prophecy. Going to need some big plays to lead the charge for Huke. And Huke actually just tosses the satellite to his opponents, trying to bait out a few kills.
Yeah, and all he's looking to do there, he's basically giving his team an extra man, you know, because when you've got the ball, you're effectively playing 3v4. If you throw the ball in the opposition space, it forces them to kind of focus on the objective, takes the focus away from you pushing up the map, and you're able to slay them.
3 down, Legal, trying to clear the satellite, gets it back to the middle of the map, just tosses it out to the halfway point, and it's actually going to reset here in 10 seconds if it's untouched. Not going to move very far. Vexy's going to grab it, and he's going to toss it out, trying to slay again. This is a battle for map control first, then they'll play for the objective. And so far, Stunner with some very nice pushes, but Prophecy, only allowing 2 points, have done a great job on defense.
Yeah, absolutely.
I was going to say 100% agree.
Ball tossed over the fence. Looks like this one is going to be resetting any moment. Parasite set up for it. He's going to go for the instant cash, and it looks like instead he's going to cut it through garage. 2 players there. Jukes back outside. Teammates there to get the cutoffs, just like a CTF game. Parasite with the launch from in front of the offices. It doesn't bounce through, just to the right. And here comes Stunner. 2 players. Stops one. Satellite still in play. And this one, did it get tossed on top of the building? It looks like they're going to have to wait for the reset.
Parasite to be hanging out waiting reset. Too.
That
was 15 second reset because it's stuck there, but Parasite's waiting in the base. If he stays alive here, they might be able to pass it to him, and they might be able to put it in a dunk to tie things up. Unfortunately, he does go down, as does 3 from Prophecy. Vexy's going to make it into the school. We might see another score before the half. He's got the help of TJ Halley. Could he dunk it? No! And he misses the toss. It's not going to be another score, but No, he's got a Huke there to try to make a play, and he won't be able to. Parasite, able to get it out. And
one more here. Prop Ricky. Pass. Okay, Ricky's going to get it out. I was nervous for him there for a moment, guys. But, I mean, Parasite almost got the bounce play, almost then converted it into a two-piece. Swanee, I got to get your thoughts. I haven't seen too many teams thrown on top of that building. Is that something that you've seen kind of a lot in competitive play? Or is that something new to
Stunner? People notice as well, if the people who tuned into the Columbus Open are watching, you'll notice that there's a lot less passing, because obviously after the update, the metagame's completely changed. Whereas before it was about passing, they've nerfed the distance of the pass though. Before you could lob it across the world, you know, you could lob it onto a different map, you could throw it that far. But now they've nerfed the passing distance, and now it's whereas you would see players playing to sneak behind enemy lines and pass it on top of the building. Now it's just about map control and kind of pushing school out and just running it in.
As a competitor, what do you prefer? Because I know the EU guys like
it. I prefer it
now,
to be honest, because I mean, with passing it was just so fluky, and it kind of reminded me a bit of Blitz, where it was just someone, you know, someone would, there'd be a player dedicated to sneaking behind, you know, enemy lines.
Yeah.
And then just playing for the pass. But now, whereas it actually takes teamwork to, you know, to clear a route for the ball carrier to get him into the enemy base. It plays a lot more like CTF now, in that you need to get the cutoffs.
Ricky, with your satellite now, you saw first it was Parasite scoring in the first 30 seconds of the round. Then four down, Stunner tries to make a push. Long range toss from Vexy, aims just left. They couldn't get the rebound either. So now we sit at 2-2, a minute into the second side, but already Propsy looking like the stronger squad and should be able to win this if they can keep up the slang. But Stunner, I'm looking through the kills. I mean, you got Vex doing some damage. TJ did some work in the first half, but where is Huke and where is Perplexed in this game?
Huke is not playing to his normal standards, really. This is a player that we talked about. A lot of hype around this guy. He's so talented. He's still so young. Right now, though, struggling against Prophecy, especially. You expect Huke to be at the top of the leaderboard, typically, in kills. And we look at him and Perplexed. They're allowing Vexy and TJ Halley to do all of it for him.
Yeah, I think the way we're seeing Prof play at the moment, I think we'll see them slowly start to break away and gain a lead on this side. I mean, Parasite, he had the initial 1 point play when they got four down, and then he just scored another two. So he's doing a lot of the objective work. And as Puckett said, you know, Parasite's proven to be the factor at the moment.
Yeah. He's actually got all of the team's uplinks, tossing it right out of bounds. It's going to be Ricky. Knows he doesn't have the support to get through high school. Heads up play. Just going to reset it, give his team a little bit better of a shot as they come out of the respawn to set up another point play. Down by three, though, is going to be your guys from Stunner on the less favorable side. Now, we talked about the push that you make when you are on the favorable side, just getting control of high school and getting in through the back door and putting the drone in the uplink. Favorable push on the less favorable side. What is it, Swanee?
I'm not sure, to be honest, because either way, the team are going to be spawning incredibly close to their flag. Yeah. You can either push it through the back alley and they'll spawn garage, or you can push it garage and they'll spawn in the green building, the fourth hard point, or right. The back, you know. I think you just want to play for kills, try and get the four down, and just literally run it through mid-road, to be honest, or play from the throw from the ambulance, which you've seen Profit notorious for it.
Huke waiting in the perfect position to stop the bounce from Ricky, and now he's trying to push this ball up through the school. He's going to go for the play ball, but I was watching Huke earlier, and he really has kind of taken over the objective role on this team. They give him the satellite, at least they did on the previous side. So far, he's been trying to play as the last line of defense, and they have not had enough personnel inside the school. If Ricky gets the melee like we've seen in the past, here's another conversion. It's going to be up to Vex now to stop this as Parasite is going in for the dunk.
Tosses the drone though so he can go for the pick, but he's not going to be able to get that kill. That drone's going to be right outside the steps of high school. Picked up by TJ Halley. He'll be grabbing this drone and taking it.
Toss.
And will he be able to get
bounce.
It in?
There it is. So there that's is. What I was going to say. Instead of going for a two-point conversion, Stunner at this point in the game needs to go for three more tosses.
Huke's going to try one. Bounces up. Tosses it. Can he get the interception for Parasite? Parasite does pick it up off the bounce.
And there's a toss. It didn't go to the school, though. It didn't go on top, of the garage. So we're going to see one more chance. Huke trying to chase down that player. Ball's still here. Can he get the pass from TJ?
He actually will be able to pick up a kill. The drone's still going to be down in the base. He's trying to stay alive, but Huke will finally drop. Parasite gets the drone out. Despite how long he was able to stay alive, they weren't able to capitalize with a dunk.
Beck's with a nice interception. These guys, if they used the pass a little bit more, I think they would have seen more success and potentially had a two-point play opportunity. Just a little too stubborn.
Yeah, I think that was a wasted opportunity from Sun, to be honest. As you said, it was a huge opportunity for a two-point play. They had the ball in the opposition face, and they somehow managed to let Parasite grab it and throw it out. You know, if it wasn't for Parasite, they'd have had base control, and they would have had 2 points.
All right, they have one more attempt. Here's a pass. It looks like Perplex is behind enemy lines. Can he get a hold of it? No. And this ball is going to be tossed out one more time. Prof is going to force a game five, boys.
And I mean, if it goes to a game five, which it is, I can only see Prof taking it, to be honest, at this point.
It's Prof? Three-game comeback?
I think even though I might have predicted Stunner to win a game five earlier, I'm changing my mind again.
All right, you're allowed to switch it up 40 more times, Swanee.
That's it, though. No more than 40.
Yeah, if you switch it up 41, you're out.
You joined
Duffman with worst predictions NA.
Are you kidding? I had great predictions at Advanced Warfare Open Columbus. Okay, man.
How is Ryze doing, by the way? Are you on the road to winning this all? All right, guys, that is going to do it for game number 4-5-3. Duffman, Swanee, and I will be right back after this bathroom break.